Yeah, so like I was saying, what's the works? The works is basically going out on the highways and, you know, fasting, prayer, going out to the highways and byways, brotherly love, okay, charity, giving tithes, all these different things are part of what? They're part of works of your faith. They basically, by doing these things, they show that you really truly believe the gift that's bestowed upon you, being out of faith, right? Let me read it again. So it says, verse 7, and everyone that shall be able to escape, that shall be saved, and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby ye have believed. Alright? So that's what's really going to allow you to establish, to basically escape from the said perils that are going to come. So let me read Isaiah, book of Isaiah. Isaiah 33, and I'm going to start from, I'll just get to the point. So it's verse 6, so it says, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time and the strength of salvation. The fear of the Lord is his treasure, right? So basically, that's what's going to allow you to maneuver through the times that we're in the midst of, right? Basically, I'll read it again, so it says, and wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy time, right? What's going to stabilize you through the times that we're presently in? Having wisdom and knowledge. Right, and the wisdom and knowledge that you gotta have, ain't you gotta go and get a degree or a PhD or whatever the world is basically bringing forth to you. It's basically, as Paul spoke of, we preach the crucifixion of the Lord. Basically, you gotta have faith in the word. All right, that's the wisdom and knowledge that's gonna stabilize you in this time. But what did the Lord say? He said that he's gonna send, he's gonna go, but he's gonna leave us the Holy Spirit in comfort. Alright? So it says, and the strength of salvation, the fear of the Lord is his treasure. Alright?
Let me read one other scripture in the book of Matthew. 24. So it's the book of Matthew, the 24th chapter.
Matthew 24 and 13, it says, but he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. Right? So it's not only that you
gotta do the works, it's that you have to endure unto the end. You have to
be found doing the works when the Lord comes. Alright? So it says, verse 8. So it says,
actually, let me start from
verse 7. So it's the book of 2nd Edges 9 and 7. It says, everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith, whereby ye have believed, shall be preserved from the said perils, and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders. Alright? So basically, the only way you're going to be saved
is by doing the works. Alright? And the reason why you want to, like you have Christians today, they'll say, I've been saved by Jesus Christ. But the saving of Jesus Christ is basically,
I read in the book of Matthew 24 that basically, he that endureth unto the end, the same shall be saved. It was only the times to come, alright, our temptation, being our temptation, the time of Jacob's trouble, that's basically going to establish a time of salvation, alright? So let me read on. So it says, let me read it again. So it says, 2nd Ezra 9 and 8, it says, shall be the same peril, and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning. Right? And that's really
And that's really what's basically going to happen. The way it's going to be, things are going to be established by what? So it's something that's been established from the beginning. And that's why the Lord said in the book of John, he spoke about those that the Lord gave him, they can't be plucked out of his hand, right? Because the Lord chose him from the beginning, ordained him from the beginning, basically, all right? So let me go carry on with 2 Ezra's 9 chapter. So it's the book of 2 Ezra 9 and 9, so it says, then shall they be in a pitiful case, which now have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torment, right? Because basically the Heavenly Father, it tells you in the book of Proverbs 18 and 10, the name of the Lord is a strong tower, the righteous runneth into it and are safe. So those that, only the righteous can dwell under that, in that tower of the Most High power, okay? But then also as well, if you ain't righteous, you're going to be outside of that tower. And this is who the scripture applies to. They're going to be in a pitiful case. All right? And this time, as we know, it says it's going to be a time like never before. All right?
Okay. If you got anything, just jump in. Then.
All right. So it says, from such... for such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, all right? And basically they sold out to Satan, all right? Because they basically, this is them basically. Who is this? It's the book of Mark.
And 36,
Mark 8,
and 36.
So it says, for what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? Alright? So basically you have people on a grandiose level. You could have the lesser illuminates dealing with
actors, rappers, stars of any sort, like athletes and whatnot. But then you also have people in the realm of business, right? They basically sold out as well. They sold themselves out. But then also you have on a lower level, you have people within the midst of the society, right?
And it could be as low as a 9-to-5. Because really what's going to establish that, what I just said, is really the time that we're in dealing with the image of the beast, right? Right now, presently, you have people that are more than willing take a vaccine basically just to have normalcy in their life again. So they basically stole their soul, alright? And really I'm dealing with you tribes, right? This ain't just any ordinary so-and-so. It's only dealing with the so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, alright? They basically sold out. So it says, verse 38, whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. Alright? So they're going to find themselves in a pitiful case. Alright? You got something?
Luke 6 and
And he lifted up his eyes on his disciples and said, Blessed be ye poor, for yours is the kingdom of the Most High. Blessed are ye that hunger now, for ye shall be filled. Blessed are ye that weep now, for ye shall laugh. Blessed are ye when men shall hate you, and when they shall separate you from their company, and shall reproach you, and cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake. Yeah, so, but for the men in this world, basically dealing with truth, then it's what becomes a matter of, you become an enemy to the world, man. Those in the world, they're not looking to mess with you. Like back when you were in the world, they would have just messed with you. Why? Because these guys, when you're in the world, these guys got legions of demons on them, man. These guys are bugged out. And then it's, when you're back in the world, you're bugged out. But then what? When you come in the truth, that's you being renewed. Becoming that new man, and then the Lord basically takes these demons off you over time, man, as you get into this word. But what? That then puts a... That then puts what? A target on your back for these people there in the world. These people in the world are looking at you like, oh, what's wrong with this guy, man? These guys are going to be smoking weed, going out partying, trying to get laid. All that vanity, you know, the love of the world, man. All that BS. And then they'll be looking at you when you're just like, nah, I'm just chilling. Or you going out teaching the scriptures, they might see you on road, be like, yo, this guy lost his mind. What the hell? What's he doing? Or what? It's we're you know.
We're basically suffering at this present time. We're sacrificing, you know, taking part in the world. What? For that reward that lies at the end. It says, verse 24. Oh well, verse 23, Rejoice ye in that day and leap for joy, for behold, your reward is great in heaven, for in the like manner did the fathers unto the prophets. But woe unto you that are rich, for ye have received your consolation. Yeah, so the brother just mentioned, talking about the lower luminaries, the guys that basically have
taken, achieved some small level of renown or so-called greatness in this world. These guys, what?
It's going to be destruction unto them, man. That's it's a consolation prize. Because what? It's all that's been built up. What's it saying in Malachi? You shall build up, but I will throw down. Yahweh Hashem Yahushua is going to basically bring about an end. All Esau's
structures he's built, all these cities, you know, all these monuments he's made to himself, these things are going to be ended and forgotten. These things are going to be broken down, and it's that all your investment in that system is going to be become clear. It's a consolation. Why? Because in the coming kingdom of heaven, all the greater you are in this kingdom,
the less you're going to be revered in the kingdom, and the more you're going to be despised in the kingdom, man. Those among the so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Americans, among Jake, that have sold out and partaken in this world. They've basically done vile acts to get some form of a place, a presence in this world. For them, they're gonna have their head down for a while, man, because they're gonna be ashamed. Why? They're realizing like, oh, when it was that basically the time Yahusha was like, yo, he needed his men to step up. They weren't partaking, man. They were fighting against him, man, and they threw in a lot of Esau.
First Peter's 4:1, it says, for as much, you can break it down, for as much then as Mashiach have suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind, for he that have suffered in the flesh have ceased from sin.
Right? Yeah, suffering in the flesh, because what is it, man?
Sirach 2. Yeah, you basically got to prepare yourself when you come to serve the Lord. You got to be in the mindset of basically abstaining from the world, of basically receiving tribulation, man. Getting
troubled by the world, man. Because hey, people don't like it. It's like as far as teaching this word, pushing this word, the truth of the word, you know. Laws, all these different things. These are reasons why the nations despise Jake, man. Because the way Jake moves, it makes these guys feel hot, man. They're basically looking like, yo, these guys are more excellent than us. That's why they've been hating from the jump, man. They were waiting for the, that's why they schemed, man. These nations, they came together. They did the research into how to ensure Jake stays down, man. They got together. You got Judith, when it's a Moabite, I believe it's, I think it's a Moabite king, talking to the Ammonites, saying like, yo, what do you know about these men?
I think it's an advisor, actually. So,
yeah. I think it's an Ammonite advisor.
Yeah.
But yeah, just and then they broke it down. Like, yo, if these guys aren't serving that, if these guys are going off, you can come against them. So that's the
And that's why he got shipped off to Jake, because the guy, and that's how they would obviously know, because you got the Moabite stone as well. But they understood that. Well, now they would more understand that. But back then they didn't, because he got shipped out of the nation, because basically to that king was like blasphemy to say that I can't beat these people because their god is so powerful. Their god is more powerful than me, basically.
Yeah. But that's now Esau knows. Esau's done his research. He says he's wiser than Daniel. Esau has made sure to keep Jake, giving them a form of godliness, but not according to knowledge, because he will basically. That plantation Christianity, where it's basically just making Jake go off, making them basically read the scriptures, but get no understanding, because there's no truth in it.
Says that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of the Most High, for the time pass of our life may suffice us to have ruled the will of the Gentiles when he walked in lasciviousness, lust, excess of wine, revelings, banqueting, and abominable idolatries, wherein they think it strange that you run not with them to the same excess of riot, speaking evil of you. Who shall give a account to him that is ready to judge the quick and the dead? Right? But that's the point, is that they think, verse 4, wherein they think it strange that you run not with them to the same excess of riot, speaking evil, because you mentioned that before. And that's saying, when you come into the faith, that's what sign is going to separate you from the people of the world, basically, the way you move, right? And then Jake is really, that's why we deal with the class of the prophets. You read it in the book of Luke, I believe 14, it basically talks about how when you had the prophets, they basically got killed at all times, because they basically come along and tell the people, like, look, man, you ain't meant to be doing this. Even an example of that is a king, what's this king? I want to say Ahab. One of the kings, I don't think it's Ahab, I think, or Ahaz, maybe. Where he said, like, you had a king from Judah come to make a war. They came together to war against Syria, I think they came along, they had a group to fight against the Assyrians or something of that nature. And basically, when they formed the union and went to fight against them, basically what you had was the king of Judah said, look, you got your prophets that, but bring a prophet of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh. And then he basically said, I don't want him to come before me, because every time he comes before me, he speaks against me. And that was basically the reason why he basically threw him into jail and said, give him bread of affliction, all right? Because basically, any time the prophets come forth, they don't speak favorably into what you want to do in your mind. They speak in accordance to the will of the Heavenly Father, all right? And you basically got to eat it, even us, all right? For us to be out here to speak of this word, we, Lord willing, count the cost, right? through the Spirit. And we know that, the Lord's will has to be accomplished. Whatever the will of the Heavenly Father is, we have to follow through with it, all right? And we just pray that we're on the righteous side of the Heavenly Father's will,
You got a sign?
Romans 11 and 7. What then? Israel hath not obtained that which he seeketh for, but the election hath obtained it, and the rest were blinded. Yeah, so that's how this word is, man. There's the election are the ones who are going to get, and everyone else has been blinded, man. And that's why they'll look at your ways and be like, yo, why are these guys moving like that? What's going on? It's even... these guys break the truth down to them. Then they'll just be like, oh, yeah, but, you know, like, if we're going to, you know, if we're going to get it in the end, no matter what, why are we even going to, you know, why would you even, you know, not just partake in the world for the time being?
Because I don't want to take part in the world, man.
Yeah. That's that carnal mindset. Because you go to, what is it, Ezekiel, it says, those that sighed and cried for the abominations that were done in the midst.
So if, really, if you're partaking in the world and you're in that righteous mindset, your spirit should be getting chafed against all the wickedness you see round about, man.
Even Esau being in power, that alone should be enough to chafe. Because why? You're just going to be like, yo, this guy is still able to just be in power and keep his neck, his foot on Jake's neck, man. Stay fucking up, Jake. Like, what? This is, but then that's why it's... they're in the spirit of wealth. According as it is written, the Most High have given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should see, and eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear. To this day, yeah, they're deaf and blind. That's how cold the Lord is. Because why? These guys, it's the same guys. You go back even from Egypt. What? You had Jake. You had Jake basically was going the hell off, man. They don't know what the hell is going on. Getting into all forms of wickedness. And then what? Afterwards, it's when Moses went up to Mount Sinai, these men had the golden calf, man. Man were going back to the idols of Egypt. That's them same Jakes. They need to get judged. They got saved last time. This time they ain't going to make it.
Well, ultimately they got judged in the wilderness. They're gonna get an immediate judgment alongside the Egyptians did. So let me read, this is the book of Romans 8 and 16. It says the spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of the Most High. And if children, then heirs of the Most High and joint heirs with HaMashiach. If so be that we suffer with him, that we may be also glorified together. And that's another reason as to why we don't participate in the world. Because the Lord said, hey, he even said, if this is my kingdom, my servants will fight, alright? He basically wanted no dealings with the world, alright? And that really shows you that you got some fucked up state of mind that you really want to part, that you would turn around and say that, oh, you should just forget about everything and participate in the world. Why would you say that? Why would you want to do that, man? Wouldn't you be, if your spirit's correct within yourself, you're gonna be like the brother said, shaped. It's gonna irritate you when things get done. Lot, take just Lot. He was vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked when he was in Sodom and Gomorrah. He couldn't stand talking to them. He had to go down to the market and do whatever he may have to do. Do any form of business that he had to do. And when he did it, he was getting vexed with the filthiness that they would have in their conversation. Alright? And that's how you should be. If you're not in tune with that spirit, then there's something wrong with you. Alright?
You know, examples in the modern day, you could even be talking to you might be at the workplace, and then, you know, have your woman that's a boss over you talking about how, you know, she's going for another promotion or whatnot. You're just like, this is all out of course.
You got people saying like,
Boris Johnson, man, I wish you could, you know, these guys are all invested in, man. They're just like, oh yeah, I really hope I get to have that summer holiday. Everyone's all invested in the world, man. They're all thinking about this place going on forever. Look at people talking about 2023, 2024, all that kind of shit. Man's talking about it like it's guaranteed to come. I'm thinking like, yo, are we even going to make it out of this year? That's a mindset hastening the day, man. The year of hastening the coming of our Lord, man. Coming of Yahweh Shinny Al Shai.
And it shows you, Salah. it shows you the pride of people, because they, like, you don't even know if you're going to make it to tomorrow. If you're reading, that's something I always think of every day. I'm like, damn, is it? Because I've had days like that where shit's happened to me. Through the spirit. I've had things where you wake up and you're like, something came right about today. And then later on, through the course of the day, some shit winds up happening. And you're like, shit, boy. I had a feeling something was going to happen. All right? And you, and really, what's going to happen is these people are going to be grind to mill. Right, because really what's going on with the pandemic right now even is it's chipping away at people's well, they don't have no fortitude, as you know, they ain't really got no form of fortitude, but the little fortitude that they have, the little that they have, is basically chipping away at them. All right, and they're basically moving to a place where it's like they're just, you know, saying that, look, whatever you want to do, I'm down with it, and we'll follow along with whatever laws you establish. And that's really down to the hopes of establishing getting to 2023, right? Whereas it's like when you live on a day-to-day basis, knowing that anytime, you know, it can be lights out, you have a different outlook on life. And when you know that, ultimately, when you know the Heavenly Father is in control of everything, that's what's really going to spur you on to do, make conscious decisions in through righteousness unto the Heavenly Father, all right?
2 Corinthians 1 and 2. Well, we start with verse 3. It says, blessed be the Most High, even the Father of our Lord, Mashiach Yahushua, the Father of mercies and the power of all comfort, who comforteth us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves.
We're comforted from the Most High by Yahushua is a comfort. It's a comforter, basically. We're comforted by His Word, the Holy Spirit. Right?
Yeah, like he wasn't a comforter, man. The guy's he's done away with. All that, that's why it's like all the folly. This how you know when that time, man. Because all the prophecies are coming true, and it's being made evident that, hey, from the apostles on down, they were right about this truth. It's been made clear who actually knows what's going on, man. Who the Spirit's dealing with. Because you know, you still got guys contending about what the mark of the beast is. But people are coming round. Why? Because you're seeing it in living color, man. You're seeing these things be pushed out. You had Russia looking at the crypto ruble. You had America said they're going to look into a crypto dollar. In China, they've done had it the crypto one already for a while, and they're expanding it. They're looking to nationalize it and get people using it, man. In the UK, you just had the first contactless store with no tills, where Amazon they call it Amazon Fresh. In the States, it's called Amazon Go. That you can see that technology is being pushed. They're basically preparing the way for just having it implanted in your body, man. Which is where these elites of Esau want to take it. So, hey, the Spirit's being made clear. But then that's why it's like people in the world, they'll hear about these things. They'll get terrified. But what for us? We have that comfort, man. We have the Word. The Yahweh Hashem Yahusha is basically revealed through the Spirit to His men. And then from the apostles on down, it's been taught. So we already know, man. We already had faith. This is what how things were going to turn out. So for us, it's not shock. But what? People in the world, it comes like a thief.